Hello students, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss second year English topic word stress. Word stress is question number 19 in the board exam. What is word stress? If a word has more than one syllable, one particular syllable should be pronounced with greater force. This quality of language is called word stress. English language has so many peculiar qualities. One of such qualities is word stress. Look at the examples. Look at the words shown on the screen: purpose, education, society, confusion, paper, combine. And one sentence is given as a model. Listen to my pronunciation. The real purpose of education is to serve the society. Here, I have pronounced all the words without proper stress marking. If we use stress marking, the pronunciation will be like this. Again, listen to me. Listen to my pronunciation of this sentence. The real purpose of education is to serve the society. Here, I have used stress marking. I have pronounced the words with proper stress marking. So, wherever stress is falling on the words, we have to use one vertical upright mark. One vertical upright mark on the syllables. First of all, we have to divide the words into syllables, syllable division. This topic we did in first year. So, word stress is nothing but extension of first year topic, syllable division. First, we have to divide the word into syllables, and appropriately we have to put one upright mark, one vertical upright mark on particular syllable according to some rules. So, there are some rules regarding word stress. Now, we are going to study those rules. So, word stress rules, they can be divided into two types: prefix rules and suffix rules. So, what is prefix? What is suffix? A letter or group of letters which comes before another word is called prefix. If it comes at the end of a word, it is called suffix. To take the example of friend, there is another word, befriend. So what is be here? Be is called prefix. And you take the example of friendship. So what is ship here? Ship is the suffix for friend, and friend is called root word. Now you have understood what prefix and suffix are. Okay, now come to the first rule, prefix rule. So what does the prefix rule say? If the word begins with prefixes a, b, d, re, con in x, a, b, d, re, con in x, put stress after the prefix. Okay, if the words begin with these prefixes a, b, d, re, con in x, put stress after the prefix. For example, along. After a, we have to use vertical line. We have to draw one vertical line. So on l, we have to draw one vertical line. So, not exactly over the letter, just before the letter. Just before the letter, we have to draw a vertical line. So, this is the way of showing the stress mark correctly. Awake on W, arise on R, across after A means on C. Similarly, belong, leave the prefix BEB. So, next letter is L. So, on L, we have to draw the vertical line stress mark. Beware, beside, begin. Decide, decrease, declare, denote, revise, recite, remind, contact, concave, converse, incite, invoke, increase, extend, extempo, exceed. So, whatever the prefix is, we have to leave the prefix, and immediately on the next letter, we have to draw a vertical line. That is the first rule. Okay, understood? Now, come to the suffix rule. In suffix, we have three rules. Okay, so the first one is, if the word ends with suffixes self, e, ear, et, ik, self, e, ear, et, ik, put stress on the last syllable. We have to put stress on the last syllable. So, examples: myself, referee, engineer, millionaire, gazette, unique. Okay. So, first of all, what we have to do is divide the word into syllables. For example, myself, myself. So, as per the rule, we have to put stress mark on the last syllable, that is on S. For example, referee, re-fer-ree. So, last syllable is re. So, on re means on R, we have to put the stress mark. Engineer, engineer. Last syllable is near, on N. Millionaire, me-li-a-ne-a. Ne-a means on N only. Gazette, cigarette, gazette. Cigarette, cigarette, on R. Unique, unique, on N, we have to put the stress mark. Okay, Now the second rule of suffix rule, words ending in un, ion, un, al, ikus, unal, ikus, take stress on the second last syllable. Okay, ion is un, not ion, ion, no, un. Il is al, not el, al, un, al, ikus. If the words end with these suffixes, un, al, ikus, they take stress on the second last syllable. Okay, example, education, vacation, preparation. So divide the words into syllables first of all. A, ju, k, shen. So last second is k. So on c we have to put the stress mark. For example, take another example, social, so, shell. Last second is beginning only, on s only. Okay. Take another example, delicious, delicious. It's not delicious, no, delicious, shes, delicious, delicious, last second is on L. Electric, electric, last second is lec, on L. Okay, now come to the third one of the suffix rule, words ending in ion, it, is, logy, graphy, ion, it, is, logy, graphy, they take stress on the third last syllable. Okay, third last syllable. In the earlier rule, stress is on the second last. Now in the third rule, stress is on the third last syllable. Example, Indian, guardian. Divide the word Indian. So last third is beginning only on I. Guardian, guardian. Last third means beginning only. Take another example, opportunity. Opportunity. Last third means on T. Okay. Emphasize. Emphasize. Last third means in the beginning only. Okay. Biology. Biology. Last third means on O. Choreography. Choreography. Last third means on O. Okay. In this way, we have to divide the words into syllables. This is the rough work. So in the fair work, we have to write the answer as shown on the screen. Now come to the third rule. Now prefix suffix rules are over. Now come to the third one. Compound words, they take stress in the beginning. Compound words means two or more words, they combine together to form a single word. Okay, they take stress in the beginning very easy. For example, toothpaste. In toothpaste, there are two words, toothpaste, but it is a single word, so it takes stress on the beginning only. Bus stop, call center, photoshop, grandfather, grandmother, handbag. So all these words, they take stress in the beginning only. Why? Because they are all compound words. Now come to the fourth one. Most of the disyllabic words which end with R take stress in the beginning. Disyllabic words which end with R, they take stress in the beginning. Okay. So author, brother, father, teacher, sister, these are disyllabic words. They have two syllables only. They end with R sound. So they take stress in the beginning only. Very easy. Now come to the fifth one. Multiples of 10 take stress in the beginning. Multiples of 10, 20, 30, 50. So they take stress in the beginning. And the numericals that end with teen, the words they end with teen, they take stress on teen itself. Okay. For example, 20, 30, 40, 50, 80, 90, they take stress in the beginning. 16, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So these words, they take stress in on T. Okay. Now, all the rules are over. Based on all these rules, we shall do an exercise. So in the words are given in the examination, first what we have to do is, whether prefix rule or suffix rule, which one we have to follow? What is given in the word? So it has whether prefix or suffix, first we have to identify. Now accordingly we have to apply the rules. Now look at these words, do on your own. Career. So on career, so prefix or suffix, year, suffix is given. 18, suffix is given. Postman, compound word. Biography, graphy, suffix. Employee, e, suffix. Musician, musician, en, suffix. Unique, unique, ik, suffix. Patriotic, ik, suffix. paper, disyllabic word ending with R, herself, self, suffix, belong, BEB, prefix, deplore, DED is given, prefix, detained, DE is given, prefix, because, BE, prefix, converge, CON, prefix, zoology, zoology, logy, suffix, examination, shen, un, ion, suffix, about, a, prefix. So, first what we have to do is, whether the word has prefix or suffix, we decide on prefix or suffix, accordingly, we have to divide the word into syllables and put the upright mark, stress mark, exactly, properly, that could be your answer, okay? In this way, we have to answer question number 19, word stress. Okay, students, I hope that you have understood this video. All the best for your exams. We meet again very soon with another interesting topic. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Jai Hind.